So here's the bed from the back. We've got a little nook here for whatever. It's currently our extension cord thing. I've got things here that we can attach bungees for, so whatever doesn't fit, you can just wrap around here, bungee it up, and it'll stay. We've got some plenty of storage under the bed. Here we've got some cooking stuff, some tools. This will be bags and extra snacks. Over on this side is more of the camping stuff, chairs, canopy, our battery charger right there, which, close this up. Comes into this box here, which is kind of a mess of wires. But we have a battery,
solenoid in there that will charge the battery from the front of the van.
All that comes to this inverter, which we can then plug stuff in, like this fan, which these two fans, which saves our lives in the night. This little table that pops out, and I like to put the fan right on that, and then it's got blowing to us. So that is our back. Come around to the side, all that grime and gunk and stuff growing on it is gone. This is just a temporary fix, but we want something very much like it, so at night we can have the windows down, but bugs don't come in. Look how beautiful that was thing. That thing was filthy before. Look at it. Come around to get to the inside. Doors open nice and wide. We've got our new floor. Here's the other view of the bed. These drawers pull out. And this is kind of where we're keeping our clothes. And then while it's moving, we've got these little latches here. Well, there we go. So they don't come out as we're driving. And one for Jenny's. Here's our bed. It is a queen size bed from side to side, but in order to fit it between window and window, I had to cut, I don't know, maybe 6 inches off, but it is just the right height. I cannot grow anymore. And it's about perfect for Jenny. It's super comfy. Built some cabinets up here with kind of a railing. These lights work. They were original with the van, but I have changed things. So there are plenty of nooks and crannies to put things on. I colored and burnt in a ruby for the van's name, Ruby. These also open up for storage. My mom had always said every car needs a sock monkey in it, so there's our sock monkey. Where the seat belts back here used to be, I have attached some heavy-duty hooks. There's four of them, so we can run lines or hang anything that we need to. Here's more of the upper cabinets that I have built. As you can see, plenty of storage for food and whatnot. That opens up. I still need to do something cooler with that, but plenty of storage. I built this in here. Some more railings. Cool little wood-burning drawing of a van camping. Here's another little end table that you can pull this off and there's some storage underneath. Here are some switches for the additional lighting and whatnot that we put in, as well as USB charger, which is very nice. And then I made this little counter area. This is all walnut up top. I think turned out pretty well. Looks really good. These drawers open up for some storage. Other one over there. And this is an additional counter space that you can pull out. So if you need to eat inside, you've got more table area. And when it's not, you can stow that away. Jenny's contribution, I Want to Grow Old With You. This was my first sewing job, was these curtains here. And when you open it up, our cooler is in there. And that is on a little platform with wheels. So when you need to access it, you can just pull it out, open it up, and then push it back in. And I've got a bungee cord that wraps around and holds that in place while we're driving. Up in the front, this is a refinished center console with a new radio. Here's buttons that also control the additional lights that we did. And these seats, both seats swivel around. Later, I'll do a video that shows that. But yeah, the light that I redid made it look a little fancier. And I bet you can see the lights work. So this is Ruby, a little camper van.